Hey y'all, it's Mei here. Today I'm going to do a makeup tutorial on the popular beauty trend glass skin. And I know I'm saying makeup tutorial, and this might surprise you because a lot of you think it might be all in the skincare people use, and that is most definitely true, but I saw a lot of videos and most of them focused on the skincare part, and since I do a lot of skincare videos already, I think you have some kind of general idea what you should use to get good skin. But also a great part of this is the makeup that people actually wear. The people behind the videos already have really great skin to start with, and I know this might be a bit frustrating for you all, since I saw also a lot of comments on those videos on step one, first have great skin. For me, I don't have great skin at all. As you know, I have rosacea and acne, so that means I have both bumps and redness as well, so that's not really a good decent beginning to start off with for the glass skin. But you might be surprised yourself. It's more about layering moisture on top of the skin and then applying makeup on that, like dewy makeup, and with that you can get really far, whether you have really good skin or you have acne prone skin, rosacea, whatever. I think this can be done by anybody. Just saying out there, just want to put this out there, if you do have oily skin, layering all this moisture might not feel really comfortable for you, but other than that, I think this look is for everyone. So without further ado, I'm going to start the video. So I hope you enjoy. So this is how my skin looks like without any makeup, and I'm going to start off by exfoliating my skin with the April Skin Magic Snow Pad. These pads contain both lactic acid and rice bran extract, which helps to exfoliate the dead skin cells off of my skin and create a nice smooth texture before applying makeup. I also like these pads by Holika Holika. They also contain AHA. Just make sure you wash off the excess and pat your skin dry before applying any other makeup or skincare. And I'm just drying my face with a cotton pad, since I don't really like towels or such. They can harvest a lot of bacteria, so I tend to avoid those. And after drying my face, I'm moving on to toner. And today I'm using the Pyunkang Mist Toner. You can use any kind of moisturizing toner for this. The Essence Toner of Pyunkang would also be a good option, since it's really moisturizing as well. Or even the Klairs Supple Preparation Toner, I think it's called. You can layer this as well if you're looking for something more hydrating. So I'm just tapping this all over my skin and then moving on to the next step, which is facial oil. And this is really important for this look. And today I'm using the Missha Super Aqua Ultra Waterfull Facial Oil. Applying a facial oil will give you that extra glow and shine without looking too oily. And this specific facial oil, it has like a oil to water ratio, which is similar to your natural oil water ratio of the skin, so it absorbs really quickly and it doesn't feel greasy or oily. So I'm just applying this to my whole face before moving on to sunscreen. And for sunscreen today, I'm using the Troiareuke UV Protector Essence. And this sunscreen has SPF 50 and PH Triple Plus. I really like to use this. This is my daily sunscreen, and it doesn't clog my pores or make me break out. So I just apply an adequate amount all over my skin, neck, and hands to just make sure I'm fully protected from those nasty sun rays. So I just applied my eye makeup quickly and then moving on to primer using the Laneige Skin Feel Base EX. This is a good primer, but it does have a pretty high white pigment next to the green pigment, so it can make your face a bit pale. So I'm only applying this to the center of my face to make sure I'm not too Adam's family. but it does cancel out the redness pretty well. So if you have rosacea or something like me, this would be a good primer. Onto my makeup base, I'm using the Troiareuke H Plus Cream, which is a medium coverage BB cream. It does only come in one color, but I think this one adjusts to the skin pretty nicely, so I'm enjoying this. Then for concealer, I'm using two today. I'm using the Klairs Creamy and Fit Natural Concealer, which I'm applying onto my dark circles. And I'm using the Skin Food Banana Concealer for my blemishes, pimples, and other dark spots. The Skin Food Banana Concealer is a bit more pigmented, and also the cream is a bit thicker, so it does a better job of covering those blemishes than I think the Klairs Creamy and Fit Natural Concealer. Now onto cheeks. I'm just using a light color today. I'm using Love 3CE Cheekmaker in the color Orangish, and this is one of my favorite blushes. The color is so pigmented, so you can apply it as heavily as you like, but I just want something healthy looking which makes my face glow. So I'm going for this color. You can also use a pink color instead, whatever you prefer. And then onto highlighter, I'm using the NYX Genius Strobe palette, and I'm just applying a highlighter on my nose bridge, the top of my lip, and as well as my jawline. I'm using a larger fan brush for my jawline. Then onto the lips, I'm using this Apieu BonoBono Creamy Cheek Chok Blusher, and this is actually a cheek color, but yeah. Finally, I'm using the Rose Heart Moisturizing Mist for that ultimate glow, and I really love this mist, it really completes this look. And then we are done. I hope you were inspired by this tutorial, just so you can see that everyone with every skin type can enjoy and can do the glass skin makeup look. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!